Well, normally I'd be saying good morning or good evening. I guess this could be both. We're recording this Mass here to share a little bit later with all of you, the people of St. Maximilian Kolbe and anyone else that may be watching. Welcome to our parish family, scattered a little bit in all of our homes and wherever we may be resting. Safety and blessings upon you. Our announcements are pretty short. This weekend we're offering Masses. I'm just going to mention all three Masses at this one so you can all see it, and then I will be praying for folks later as well. Our 5 o'clock Mass was birthday blessings for Jenny and Raymond Spring and the health of Leilani Spring. The 8:30, we're going to pray for Margaret Troutman, and the 11 o'clock, Anna Tellerico and Dr. Charles Lesh. Normally we'd be greeting each other at this time, but through the power of the internet, we certainly have comments down below. If you want to say hi to folks, we'd be encouraging people to use that in different ways throughout our celebration. But let's pray together our spiritual adoption prayer and our prayer for healing. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, I love you very much. I beg you to spare the life of the unborn child that I have spiritually adopted, who is in danger of abortion. Amen. O merciful Father, your Son in love stretched out his hands upon the cross to embrace us. Embrace and heal our brothers and sisters who carry the wounds of abuse inflicted upon them. Heal your church broken by this betrayal of trust. Cleanse and sanctify your clergy that they may radiate the selfless love of your Son. And strengthen and call the people of the church throughout Western New York to a new dawn of hope and grace in your Holy Spirit. And we ask this through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Dying for light, we wait in darkness, longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own. Your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gathered today. Longing for peace, our world is troubled. Longing for hope, many despair. Your word alone has power to save us. Make us your living voice. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts. Shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church, gathered today. Welcome, everyone, to this video celebration of the Mass. And let us begin wherever we are in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, as we begin our celebration, let us examine our hearts. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who through your word reconcile the human race to yourself in a wonderful way, grant, we pray, that with prompt devotion and eager faith, the Christian people may hasten toward the solemn celebrations to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. And one of the advantages, actually, of doing Mass like this in a sort of a video as opposed to doing it live or even on TV is that you can pause. You can take a moment to run to the bathroom, I guess, if you need to. But if you want to spend a little bit longer reflecting on the examination of conscience, you can do that. If something in these scripture readings really strikes you, you can pause for a moment and reflect on it. So as we go through these readings, let the Spirit stir in your heart. And our first reading comes from the first book of Samuel. The Lord said to Samuel, "Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I am sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem, for I have chosen my king from among his sons." As Jesse and his sons came to the sacrifice, Samuel looked at Eliab and thought, "Well, surely the Lord's anointed is here before him." But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not judge from his appearance or from his lofty stature, because I have rejected him. Not as man sees does God see, because man sees the appearance, but the Lord looks into the heart." In the same way, Jesse presented seven sons before Samuel, but Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any one of these." Then Samuel asked Jesse, "Are these all the sons you have?" Jesse replied, "There is still the youngest who is tending the sheep." Samuel said to Jesse, "Send for him. We will not begin the sacrificial banquet until he arrives here." Jesse sent and had the young man brought to them. He was ruddy, a youth handsome to behold and making a splendid appearance. The Lord said, "There, anoint him, for this is the one." Then Samuel, with the horn of oil in hand, anointed David in the presence of his brothers, and from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon David, the word of the Lord.
Our response is Psalm 23.
Shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful water he leads me.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley,
shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my
is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of the light, for light produces every kind of goodness and righteousness and truth. Try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord. Take no part in the fruitless works of darkness. Rather, expose them, for it's shameful even to mention the things done by them in secret. But everything exposed by the light becomes visible, for everything that becomes visible is light. Therefore, it says, awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Glory and praise to my God, my Jesus Christ.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I have the light of the world, saith the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And your
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. As Jesus passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, neither he nor his parents sinned. It is so that the works of God might be made visible through him. We have to do the works of the one who sent me while it is day. Night is coming when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world. When he had said this, he spat on the ground and made clay with the saliva, and smeared the clay on his eyes, and said to him, go wash in the pool of Siloam, which means sent. So he went and washed and came back, able to see. His neighbors and those who had seen him earlier as a beggar said, isn't this the one who used to sit and beg? Some said it is, but others said, no, he just looks like him. He said, I am. So they said to him, how were your eyes opened? He replied, the man called Jesus made clay and anointed my eyes and told me, go to Siloam and wash. So I went there and washed and was able to see. And they said to him, where is he? He said, I don't know. They brought the one who was once blind to the Pharisees. Now Jesus had made clay and opened his eyes on a Sabbath. So then the Pharisees also asked him how he was able to see. He said to them, he put clay on my eyes and I washed and now I can see. So some of the Pharisees said, this man is not from God because he does not keep the Sabbath. But others said, how can a sinful man do such signs? And there was a division among them. So they said to the blind man again, what do you have to say about him since he opened your eyes? He said, he is a prophet. Now the Jews did not believe that he had been blind and gained his sight until they summoned the parents of the one who had gained his sight. They asked them,
Is this your son who you say was born blind? How does he now see?" His parents answered and said, "We know that this is our son and that he was born blind. We do not know how he sees now, nor do we know who opened his eyes. Ask him. He's of age. He can speak for himself." His parents said this because they were afraid of the Jews, for the Jews had already agreed that if anyone acknowledged him as the Christ, he would be expelled from the synagogue. For this reason, his parents said, "He is of age, question him." So a second time they called the man who had been blind and said to him, "Give God the praise. We know that this man is a sinner." He replied, "If he is a sinner, I do not know. One thing I do know is that I was blind, and now I see." So they said to him, "What did he do to you? How did he open your eyes?" He answered them, "I told you already, and you did not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? Do you want to become his disciples too?" They ridiculed him and said, "You are that man's disciple. We are disciples of Moses. We know that God spoke to Moses, but we do not know where this one is from." The man answered and said to them, "This is what is so amazing, that you do not know where he is from, yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not listen to sinners, but if one is devout and does his will, he listens to him. It is unheard of that anyone ever opened the eyes of a person born blind. If this man were not from God, he would not be able to do anything." They answered and said to him, "You were born totally in sin, and are you trying to teach us?" And they threw him out. When Jesus heard that they had thrown him out, he found him and said, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" He answered and said, "Who is he, sir, that I may believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have seen him, and the one speaking with you is he." He said, "I do believe, Lord," and he worshiped him. Then Jesus said, "I came into this world for judgment, so that those who do not see might see, and those who do see might become blind." Some of the Pharisees who were with him heard this and said to him, "Surely we are not also blind, are we?" Jesus said to them, "If you were blind, you would have no sin. But now you're saying, 'We see,' so your sin remains." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm used to like walking and talking here, kind of stuck behind the altar, behind my desk. But welcome again, everyone, to our celebration today. We're at a kind of a moment, it seems, where this year has been going on forever, and yet it's hardly begun. There's some references in the gospel today to Moses, and it seems like we're surrounded by biblical plagues. You know, Australia was burning to the ground until it was underwater. We've had locusts in Africa, plagues of locusts, earthquakes, volcanoes, and now, of course, a disease that has all of us in our homes. So as biblical people, I think there's a little anxiety there, perhaps. And I think that we sort of have that concern addressed in this gospel today. Is all of this happening, like it did in Moses' day, because of sin? And Jesus points to this person who is in need, and I should say that the disciples actually point him out, and the disciples just sort of assume that it's because of sin when they see problems. Surely it's because of sin. It's got to be somebody's fault. Either it's the man's fault or it's his parents' fault. Who are we going to blame for this? And
Jesus does not blame either of them. He says it's not because of their sin. Instead, he says that God has something going on here, and that God is going to use this as an opportunity to bring healing. And so, as we gather for this celebration today, we certainly pray for healing. But the way that Jesus brings healing is sort of funny. That he's spitting in the dirt and rubbing dirt in people's eyes. Please don't try to heal corona by spitting in people's eyes. All right. This image, if I remember my seminary classes correctly, is one of recreation and of new birth. So in the old days, in the Old Testament, at the very beginning, God fashioned us out of the clay of the earth. And Jewish thinkers said, well, you can't really make a clay pot out of dry clay. You have to mix it with something wet. And so they concluded that it was God sort of spitting into the ground to moisten the clay. Kind of a gross image, I guess. But this was actually a noble thing in their minds. That God spit into the earth and mixed the humble earth with something divine, something directly of God, a part of God that made us unique and special and blessed. And so this combination of body and spirit, or clay and spit, is sort of what we are today. So Jesus here is recreating this person on a new Sabbath, or on the literal Sabbath, but it's a new creation on this day that God rested. And so he's able to bring healing to this person as he is recreated. And then throughout the whole gospel, there's themes of blindness and sin. This person who was born blind, he's slowly coming to faith. And it takes him a while to get there. But this deeper healing is what Jesus really wants. Even beyond any kind of physical healing, any kind of physical blindness, he wants us to be able to come to faith. He wants us to be able to be close to him. Now, I've talked a little bit in these videos already about some of the restrictions that we're all under because of the coronavirus. We can't have Mass with a congregation in a physical way, so we're having Mass with a congregation in a virtual way. And I can't administer sacraments in the way that I was before. I can't give you communion unless it's a situation where you're near death. So we're doing more and more things that are virtual as we reach out and try to connect with one another. Ultimately, as the body of Christ, we are still responsible for bringing about this healing. Some of you may be working in medical fields and doing that kind of healing with very ordinary tools, as Jesus used clay to heal in this instance. That is a perfectly fine way to heal people. Jesus often used ordinary things to work his miracles, bread and wine and fish and clay. And some of you also may have neighbors and those who are in need immediately around you. So be mindful of those and try to think how we can get them what they need. And so I'm going to pause for a moment to pray the creed and then turn in prayer to those who most need help. And so we pray, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, life everlasting. Amen. So mindful of this world's many needs, let us turn to our Heavenly Father in prayer. For the Church, may God help us to remain faithful to all of his commandments and grow in the fullness of the truth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
For elected officials, may the Lord grant them the fortitude to remain true to his justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, may the healing power of Jesus come upon them and bring them comfort and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may the healing touch of the Lord Jesus bring them comfort and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our military, first responders, and medical personnel, may the Holy Spirit guide them in their efforts in protecting, supporting, and healing those harmed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they, through the mercy of God, rest in the fullness of peace. For Geraldine Bartakovich, for those listed in our Book of Life, the souls in purgatory, and in a special way again for at our various scheduled masses this weekend, the 5 o'clock for birthday blessings for Jenny and Raymond Spring and the health of Leilani Spring. For our 8:30, Margaret Troutman. For the 11, Anna Tallarico and Dr. Charles Lesh. And we offer this Eucharist for those birthday blessings, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, may they be heard and answered. And a couple suggestions here as we pause for a moment. I'm keeping here on the altar our parish directory. This was something I had hoped to update sometime soon. That's going to be delayed now. But if you have one of these, now would be the time to get it out and keep it handy. These are the people that are in our parish family. Some of them have moved away, some of them have passed. And we have new people in our family as well, of course. But simply to flip through the book and pause a moment to pray for these people, for our family. And if the Lord stirs your heart in particular to reach out with your clay, with your hands, to help any of them in any way, even just with a phone call. You know, many of us have switched over to cell phones, so some of this information is out of date. But pause for a moment to lift up these parishioners. We pray to the Lord. And if you have any prayer requests as well, good to add them in comments below the video, asking people to pray, and scroll down and see what other people may have posted, if anyone has, and offer those intentions as well. We pray to the Lord. Oh, Heavenly Father, you know our needs. Hear now our prayers, which we offer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we receive the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Let us pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We place before you with joy these offerings, which bring eternal remedy, O Lord, praying that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as is fitting, for the salvation of all the world. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. And by the mystery of the Incarnation, he has led the human race that walked in darkness into the radiance of the faith, and has brought those born in slavery to ancient sin through the waters of regeneration, to make them your adopted children. And therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out and without end acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth. Pleni sunt caeli in terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who've pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, 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 amen.
And now at the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you, and peace be with all of you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Come to me.
let us pray. O God, who enlighten everyone who comes into this world, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty and love you in all sincerity. Through Christ our Lord. Just announcements, I guess. Feel free to post below in the comments if you've got any kind of questions for me, anything I can answer. Certainly you can do that. You could call us at the office or email, and we'll try to get back to you. Prayer intentions as well, or any kind of needs, go ahead and post below, or just ideas for helping each other out. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Have a great week, everyone.
Grace renewed by your most holy.